Hi everyone, this is Maverick Phua, the chemistry guru. Now in this video, we want to go through the step-by-step description of electrophilic substitution mechanism of benzene. Now before we describe the mechanism proper, what we want to go through again is based on the functional group benzene, can I deduce why does it undergo electrophilic substitution reaction? Again, we have two components to this mechanism, electrophilic substitution. The first part will be the electrophilic portion. Why would benzene react with an electrophile? This is fairly straightforward. Based on the charge of my carbon, I can deduce what reactive species reacts with benzene. So if I look at benzene, because inside this benzene ring, we have six delocalized electrons, we say that benzene is electron rich. If it is electron rich, then it will attract something that is electron deficient or electron poor. So therefore, what we know is benzene can react with an electrophile, which is an E plus. But it doesn't react with a nucleophile, which is a Nu minus. Again, this idea is fairly straightforward. If my benzene is electron rich, itself is a nucleophile, it cannot react with another nucleophile, it can only react with an electrophile. Now, how about substitution? Now, if you look at the degree of saturation of my carbon, in general, if it is unsaturated, it will undergo addition reaction. If it is saturated, it tends to undergo substitution reaction. If it is saturated, then in general, it cannot add in a group and carbon will have five bonds. It's not possible. So what it has to do is it has to undergo substitution reaction if the carbon is saturated or the carbon has four sigma bonds. What is interesting for benzene is if I look at the degree of saturation of carbon in benzene is actually unsaturated. We know that each of these carbon has only three sigma bonds. There's a sigma bond to a carbon, another neighboring carbon. There's actually a hidden hydrogen, which I'm showing here. So altogether, this carbon actually only has three sigma bonds. One of its electron is delocalized into the pi system. Each of these carbon is actually contributing one electron, and altogether we have six of these electrons that are delocalized. So if I look at the degree of saturation of carbon here, this carbon is actually unsaturated. Now, if it is unsaturated, then why doesn't it undergo addition reaction and become saturated? The reason is because benzene actually likes this resonance stability because of the delocalization of pi electrons. Now, delocalization of pi electrons and resonance stability in A-level chemistry, it is a very big deal. A lot of species that we encounter in A-level chemistry when stabilized by resonance are a lot more stable. So in general, we need to understand that if a species can be stabilized by resonance, then as much as possible, it will want to keep this resonance stability. So same for benzene, because it wants to retain this resonance stability. So what must happen is this delocalized pi system must be retained. If it undergoes addition reaction, it will lose the delocalized pi system, it will lose this resonance stability, which benzene doesn't want. So what you will do is you prefer substitution reaction instead of addition reaction. All right, now there are two reactions that we want to discuss. The first one will be nitration of benzene to give me nitrobenzene. This reaction is done using concentrated HNO3 in concentrated H2SO4 catalyst at 50 to 60 degrees Celsius. Now basically, the mechanism is broken down into three steps. Now the first step is to generate the electrophile because benzene is relatively stable, so we need to make HNO3 a little bit more attractive to benzene. So this reaction would be done between HNO3 and the catalyst H2SO4. So the first step will be something like this. HNO3 will react with 2H2SO4. This is actually a reversible reaction. Then what you generate is your electrophile, which is my NO2 plus, the nitro group, plus 2HSO4 minus and a H3O plus. So this will be the first step. Now second step, once I generate the electrophile NO2 plus, so what benzene will do is it will be able to attack the electrophile. So I can draw out my benzene here and I will draw the nitro group NO2 plus. Now when I draw the arrow pushing, what we show is we show an arrow from electron rich to electron poor region. The electron rich region, of course, will be the ring, benzene ring, where I have six delocalized pi electrons, and I'll point it to nitrogen because out of this NO2 plus group, the nitrogen is the one that's positively charged. So once this happens, this is considered as my slow step. Now what will happen is one of these carbon is actually taking two electrons inside this delocalized pi system and forming a bond with nitrogen. So what I can show is I will show my six carbon first. Then one of these carbon is bonded to my nitro group. And this carbon also has a hydrogen that is originally attached to it. Now, as mentioned, this carbon is taking two electrons from the benzene ring of the delocalized pi system and forms a bond with nitrogen. So effectively, I'm forming a CN bond. But what happens now is inside this delocalized pi system, I'm short of two electrons. Instead of six electrons, now I only have four electrons. So the delocalization actually is broken. The ring actually opens and we have to show that this region around the carbon that's forming a bond with the nitro group is actually breaking this delocalized system. So what we have to do is we have to show this open ring, and the part where the ring is broken is at this carbon, and inside here I have a positive charge because now the delocalized system is losing the electron to this carbon, which uses it to form a bond with the nitro group. So we'll have something like this. Of course, this intermediate looks ugly, correct? Two things. First thing is benzene is positively charged, which it doesn't like at all. It wants to be neutral. The second thing is it loses the resonance stability. So because of this, this intermediate is highly unstable. So what this intermediate will try to do is it will try to kick out the H plus to restore the delocalized pi system. So that will be in step three. Now step three, what we will have is I'll just duplicate this guy. Then, as mentioned, what it will do is it will kick out H plus. So the carbon hydrogen bond will break. Both electrons will go back to the ring. And so this step will be my fast step. And what I'll do is I'll draw my benzene. Now the ring is restored because now the CH bond is broken. Both electrons go back to benzene. So now the delocalized pi system again has six electrons. So the ring is restored. The nitro group will now be bonded to the carbon. And I'm kicking out a H plus. Now what this H plus will do is this H plus actually will combine with one of HSO4 minus to regenerate my catalyst. So I'll put HSO4 minus here as the reactant in the third step. Then you end up with H2SO4, which shows that our catalyst is regenerated. Now the second reaction we want to talk about is bromination. Bromination from benzene to bromobenzene is done using bromine in a catalyst, FeBr3 catalyst. Now the idea is the same. The first step for this mechanism is I need to generate the electrophile. So what happens in the first step is I'll have a Br2. It will react with FeBr3 catalyst to give me my electrophile Br plus and FeBr4 minus. Now step two, what I'll have is essentially the same as nitration. I have benzene. And what it does is once I have this electrophile, Br plus, this benzene will attack the Br plus. Again, when we draw the arrow pushing, it's the same thing. I draw from the ring, point to Br plus. And this is slow step. What I'll get, same as the previous case, one of the carbon will take two electrons from the ring, forms a bond with bromine. So let's say if I'm using the carbon that's pointing up, so this carbon is forming a bond with Br, then originally it has its own hydrogen, and because this carbon is taking two electrons from the benzene ring, so what this means is the ring will open. I have to draw an open ring, and inside I have to put a plus charge because the positive charge from the Br plus is being passed on to the benzene. So this would be the intermediate, which again is highly unstable. First thing is carbon is positively charged, which you totally don't like, and it loses the resonance stability. So the intermediate is highly unstable. You try to kick out a H plus. So that will be my third step. So step three, again, what I do is I can just duplicate this guy and I do a deprotonation. I remove the H plus. I break the CH bond. Both electrons will go back to benzene. And this will be the fast step. What I'm forming is benzene with the delocalized system restored. And now it's bonded to Br. So this will be my product, bromobenzene. And because it is a deprotonation, it kicks out H+. This H plus will combine with FeBr4- intermediate to form back the catalyst and another byproduct. So I have to put in FeBr4-. So effectively, this H plus, once it leaves this intermediate, this H plus will combine with FeBr4-. It will regenerate my catalyst FeBr3, and my byproduct will be HBr. Alright, so that was the discussion involving electrophilic substitution mechanism of benzene. If you learned something useful from this video, please give me the thumbs up and subscribe to my YouTube channel for more weekly video lessons. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.